This is the story of how Flynn died. Don't worry, this is actually a very funny story. And the truth is, it isn't even about Flynn. This is the story of a girl named Rapunzel. And it starts with the sun. Now, once upon a time, a single drop of sunlight fell from the heavens. And from that small drop of sun grew a magic golden flower. It had the ability to heal the sick and injured. Oh, you see that old woman over there? You might want to remember her. She's kind of important. Well, centuries passed, and a hop, skip, and a boat ride away, there grew a kingdom. The kingdom was ruled by a beloved king and queen. And the queen, well, she was about to have a baby. But then she got sick. Really sick. She was running out of time. And that's when people usually start to look for a miracle. Or in this case, a magic golden flower. Oh, I told you she'd be important. You see, instead of sharing the sun's gift, this woman, Mother Gothel, hoarded its healing powers and used it to keep herself young for hundreds of years. And all she had to do was sing a special song.
What once was mine, what once was mine.
All right, you get the gist. She sings to it, she turns young. Creepy, right? The magic of the golden flower healed the queen. A healthy, beautiful girl, a princess, was born with beautiful golden hair. I'll give you a hint. That's Rapunzel. To celebrate her birth, the king and queen launched a flying lantern into the sky. And for that one moment, everything was perfect. And then that moment ended.
Flower, gleam and glow. Let your power shine. Make the clock rip.
Gothel broke into the castle, stole the child, and just like that, gone. The kingdom searched and searched, but they could not find the princess. For deep within the forest, in a hidden tower, Gothel raised the child as her own. Gothel had found her new magic flower, but this time she was determined to keep it hidden.
Why can't I go outside?
The outside world is a dangerous place, filled with horrible, selfish people. You must stay here, where you are safe. Do you understand, flower?
Yes, mother.
But the walls of the tower could not hide everything. Each year, on her birthday, the king and queen released thousands of lanterns into the sky, and hoping that one day their lost princess would return.
Well, I guess Pascal isn't hiding over here.
gotcha.
That's 22 for me. How about 23 out of 45? Well, what do you want to do? And so do you. Oh, come on, Pascal. Not so bad in here.
I could get used to a view like this.
Flynn, come on!
Hold on. Yup, I'm used to it. Guys, I want a castle.
We do this job, you can buy your own castle.
Okay. Hay fever?
Oh, gentlemen, look what we've done! It's only 8 a.m. in the morning! This is a very big day!
This is it. This is a very big day, Pascal.
I'm finally gonna do it.
I'm gonna ask her.
Rapunzel!
It's time.
Rapunzel, let down your hair!
Coming, Mother.
I'm not getting any younger down here. Hello, dear.
Welcome home, Mother.
Oh, Rapunzel, how you manage to do that every single day without fail. It looks absolutely exhausting, darling.
Oh, it's nothing.
Then I don't know why you take so long. Darling, I'm only teasing. I have had the most eventful, beautiful, and amazing day.
That's great, Mother. As you know, tomorrow is a very big day.
Really?
Yeah?
You don't Rapunzel, look in that mirror. You know what I see? I see a strong, confident, beautiful young lady. Oh, look, you're there too. Darling, I'm only teasing. Don't take everything so seriously.
So, Mother, tomorrow...
Rapunzel, Mother's feeling a bit run down. Would you sing for me, dear?
Oh, of course, Mother. Flower, gleam, and glow, let your power shine. Make the clock of race mingle with mine. Hear what has been heard. Change of faces
on. Rapunzel.
Mother, there's something I need to tell you. I'm turning 18 tomorrow. There's something that I want. Well, I really, 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 really want.
Rapunzel, stop it with the mumbling. You know how I feel about the mumbling. Blah, 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 blah. It's very annoying.
I'm just teasing, darling. I love you so much.
Mother, there's something I need to tell you.
Do go on, Rapunzel.
I want to see the floating lights.
What?
Well, I was hoping you'd take me to see the floating lights.
Oh, you mean the stars.
That's the thing. I've charted stars. And they're always constant. But these, they appear every year on my birthday. Only on my birthday. And I can't help but feel like they're meant for me. I have to see the mother, and not just from my window. In person. I have to know what they are.
You want to go outside? Huh. Why, Rapunzel?
Look at you, as fragile as a flower. Still a little sapling, just a sprout. You know why we stay up in this tower?
I know.
That's right, to keep you safe and sound.
Guess I always knew this day was coming.
Knew that soon you'd want to leave the nest.
Soon, but not yet.
Mother, trust me, pet. Mother knows best. Mother knows best. Take it from your mother. It's a scary world out there. Mother knows best. One way or another, something will go wrong, I swear.
Ruffians, thugs, poison ivy, quicksand, cannibals and snakes, the plague.
What?
Yes, also large bugs, men with pointy teeth, and stop no more, you'll just upset me.
Mother's right here. Mother will protect you. Darling, here's what I suggest.
Skip the drama, stay with Mama. Mother knows best. Go ahead, get trampled by a rhino. Go ahead, get mugged and left for dead. Me, I'm just your mother, what do I know? I only bathed and changed and nursed you.
Go ahead and leave me!
I deserve it. Let me die alone here, be my guest. When it's too late, you'll see. Just wait. Mother knows best.
Mother knows best. Take it from your mumsy. On your own, you won't survive. Sloppy, underdressed, immature, clumsy, please, they'll eat you up alive. Gullible, naive, positively grubby, ditzy and a bit, well, vague. Plus, I believe you're getting kind of chubby. I'm just saying, 'cause I love you. Mother understands. Mother's here to help you. All I have is one request.
Rapunzel?
Yes?
Don't ever ask to leave this tower again.
Yes, Mother.
Oh, I love you very much, dear.
I love you more.
I love you most. Don't forget it. You'll regret it. Mother knows best.
I won't be long, Rapunzel. I'm taking a trip to the farmer's market.
How long will you be gone?
2 hours, maybe. You look shabby.
Thank you.
I'll see you.
I'll be here.
Thank you.
my mother's love. I shouldn't ask for more. I've got so many things I'm thankful for. Yes, I've got everything except, I guess, a door. Perhaps it's better stay in. But tell me, when will my life begin?
No! This is bad. This is very, very bad. They got my nose wrong.
Who cares?
Well, it's easy for you to say. You guys look amazing.
I know.
All right, here's the plan. We'll go from there, okay?
Give us a session first.
Flynn!
Idiots!
Hey, this is my satchel. I said, this is my satchel. Alone at last. Thank you.
Rapunzel.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel, let down your hair!
One moment, Mother!
I have a big surprise!
Oh, I do too!
Oh, well, I bet my surprise is bigger!
I seriously doubt that.
We'll see about that. Guess what? I brought back parsnips. I'm going to make hazelnut soup for dinner. Your favorite. Surprise!
Mother, there's something I need to tell you.
I hope we're still not talking about the stars, Rapunzel.
Well, I'm leading up to that.
Because I really thought we'd drop the issue, sweetheart.
No, Mother, I'm just saying. You think I'm not strong enough to handle myself out there?
Oh, darling, I know you're not strong enough to handle yourself out there.
But if you just...
Rapunzel, we're done talking about this.
Trust me.
Rapunzel.
I know what I'm saying.
Enough of the lights, Rapunzel! You are not leaving this tower! Ever! Oh, now I'm the bad guy.
All I was gonna say, Mother, is... I know what I want for my birthday now.
And what is that?
Paint? From those white shells you once brought me?
Well, that is a very long trip, Rapunzel. Almost 3 days' time.
I just thought it was better then. The stars.
All right, then.
You're gonna get the paint?
I'm going to get the paint, Rapunzel. Don't push it.
Okay, sorry, Mother.
Make sure to do all your chores and be asleep before 8.
I promise I'll do everything.
I'll be back in 3 days' time. I love you very much, dear.
I love you more.
I love you most.
I know I look shabby.
And tempting all the steps to follow closer right behind. Is it only when you feel the pot is empty that it's gnawing at the corners of your mind? Ooh, I will ask you for mercy. I will come to you blind. What you'll see is the worst me, not the last of my kind.
Struggling is pointless.
Huh?
I know why you're here, and I'm not afraid of you.
What?
Who are you, and how did you find me?
Hmm.
Who are you, and how did you find me?
I may not know who you are, nor how I come to find you. But may I just say, hi, how you doing? The name's Flynn Rider. How's your day going, huh?
Who are you, Flynn Rider?
All right, Blondie.
Rapunzel.
Gesundheit. Here's my situation here. Gallivanting through the forest, I came across... Where's my satchel?
I've hidden it somewhere where you'll never find it.
It's in that pot, isn't it? Would you stop that?
Now it's in somewhere where you'll never find it. So, what do you want to do with my hair? To cut it? Sell it?
Listen, the only thing I want to do is to get out of here. Literally.
So, you don't want my hair?
Why on earth would I want your hair? I was being chased, I climbed your tower. End of story.
You're telling the truth?
Yes.
I think he's telling the truth. I need someone to take me. I think I have an idea. Okay, Flynn Rider, I'm prepared to offer you a deal.
Deal?
Look this way. Do you know what these are?
You mean the lantern thing they do for the princess?
Lanterns? I knew they weren't stars! Well, tomorrow evening, they'll light the night sky with these lanterns. You will act as my guide. Take me to see those lanterns. Bring me back home safe. Then, and only then, will I return you your precious satchel. That is my deal.
Yeah. No can do. Unfortunately, the kingdom and I aren't exactly simpatico at the moment. So, I won't be taking you anywhere.
Call it what you want. Fate, destiny,
a horse.
But I have made it my decision to trust you.
A horrible decision, really.
But trust me when I tell you this. You can tear about this tower brick by brick. But without my help, you will never find your precious satchel.
Let me get this straight. I take key to see the lanterns, bring you back home, and then you'll give me back my satchel?
I promise. And when I promise something, Flynn Rider, I never break that promise. Ever.
I really didn't want this to happen, but you leave me no choice. Here comes the smolder. This is kind of an off day for me. This doesn't normally happen.
Yeah.
Fine, I'll take you to see the lantern.
Really? Oops, sorry.
You coming, Blondie?
So big, do I even dare? Look at me there at last, I just have to do it. Should I? No. Here I go. Racing and dancing and chasing and leaping and bounding, you're flying. can't believe I did this. I can't believe I did this. Oh my God, Mother would be furious. But that's okay. I mean, what she doesn't know won't kill her, right? Oh my God, this would kill her. But this is so fun. I have to go back. I can't go back. I'm never going back. Oh, I'm a despicable human being.
You seem a little bit at war with yourself here.
What?
Now, I'm only picking up bits and pieces, of course. Overprotective mother, forbidden road trip. I mean, that is serious stuff. But let me see your conscience. This is part of growing up. A little rebellion, a little adventure. It's good. Healthy, even.
You think?
I know. You're way overthinking this. But will this break your mother's heart and crush her soul? Of course.
Break her heart?
In half.
Crush her soul?
Like a grape.
You're right.
I am, aren't I? Oh, bother. The deal's off.
What?
That's right. But don't thank me now. Let's just head back, get your pan and your frog. I get back my satchel, and you have a mother-daughter relationship based on mutual trust. And voila, we part as unlikely friends.
No, I'm seeing those lanterns.
Oh, what is it gonna take to get back my satchel?
I will use this. What is it, ruffians? Thugs? Have they...
Stay calm. It can probably smell fear.
Sorry. I guess I'm a bit jumpy.
Yeah. Better be away from ruffians and thugs, though.
Oh, that would be great.
Yeah. Are you hungry? I know a great place for lunch.
Oh, where?
Oh, you'll know it when you smell it.
Oh, it's just a palace horse. Where's your rider? Rapunzel! Rapunzel!
Garçon, your finest table, please. You smell that? Take a deep breath through the nose. Really let that seep in. What are you getting? Because to me, that's part man smell and the other part is really bad man smell. I don't know why, but overall it just smells like the color brown. Your thoughts?
That's a lot of hair.
Is that dirt on your lips? Hey, Goldie, look at all the dirt on his lips. That, sir, that's a lot of dirt. Hey, Blondie, you don't seem so good. Maybe we should get you back home, call it a day. I mean, this is a 5-star joint after all, and if you can't handle this place, then maybe you should be back in your tower.
Is this you?
Oh, now they're just being mean!
Oh, it's him, all right! Greedo! Go call the guard! They want to go buy me a new hook!
I could use the money.
Gentlemen, we can fix this.
Wait!
We can fix this!
Leave him alone! I said stop! where I am, and I need him to take me to see the lanterns, because that's what I've been dreaming of my entire life. Haven't you ever had a dream?
I had a dream once.
I'm malicious, mean and scary. My snare could curdle dairy, and violence-wise, my hands are not the cleanest.
Yeah.
But despite my evil look and my temper and my hook, I've always yearned to be a concert pianist. Can't you see me on the stage performing Mozart, tickling the eyes till they gleam? Yup, I'd rather be called deadly for my killer show tune medley. And so, 'cause man, deep inside, I've got a dream.
He's got a dream. He's got a dream.
See, I ain't as cruel and vicious as I seem. Though I do like breaking femurs, you can count me with the dreamers. Like everybody else, I've got a dream.
La, 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 la.
But despite my exit toes and my gorge and my nose, I really wanna make a love connection. Can't you see me with a special little lady
growing in a robot death
dream?
Though I'm a disgusting bladder,
I'm a lover, not a fighter.
Wait up, deep inside, I've got a dream. I've got a dream.
He's got a dream.
I've got a dream.
He's got a dream.
No one dare romance
or it's a pretty.
There's
a child behind it dreaming.
Like everybody else, I've got a dream. Taurus like to clear the forest. Gunther does interior design. Elf is into my Attila's cupcakes are sublime.
Cruisiness, killer sauce, thankless little puppet shows.
And Vladimir collects ceramic unicorns.
What about you? Do you have a dream?
I don't do songs. I have dreams like you know, really. Just much less that you feel me. They normally happen somewhere warm and sunny. On an island that I own, tan and rusted and alone. Surrounded by enormous piles of money.
I've got a dream.
She's got a dream.
I've got a dream.
She's got a dream.
I just wanna see the floating lanterns gleam.
Yeah!
And with every passing hour, I'm so glad I left my tower. Like all you lovely folks, I've got a dream.
She's got a dream, he's got a dream, we got a dream, we got a dream. So our difference isn't really that extreme. We're one big team.
Call us brutal,
it's a distance. And got us really optimistic.
Cause we're down deep inside, I've got a dream.
I've got a dream.
I've got a dream.
Yes, we're down deep inside, I've got a dream.
Where's Ryder? Where is he? I know he's in here somewhere. Find him! Turn the place upside down if you have to!
Sir, there's no sign of Ryder.
Maximus, find him now! What's this? Get out of my way! Get up! Faster! A passage! Come on, man, let's go! Conley, make sure those boys don't get away! Play it safe. We'll go get the crown.
I just found me a tall drink of water.
Oh, stop it, you big lug. Where does that tunnel lead out?
Nine!
Go live your dream.
I will.
Not you.
Your dream stinks. I was talking to her.
Thank you for everything.
Well, I must say, that was pretty impressive.
I know. I know. So, Flynn, where are you from?
Blondie. I don't do backstory. But I am becoming pretty interested in yours. Now, I know I'm not supposed to mention the mother.
Nope.
Or the hair.
Mm-mm.
Frankly, I'm too scared to ask about the frog.
Chameleon.
Nuisance. Here's my question, though. If you really wanted to leave the tower, why haven't you left before? Yes?
Flynn? Flynn? Who's that?
He doesn't like me. Run.
Flynn, who are they?
They don't like me either. This way. Oh.
Who's that?
Let's just assume that everyone here does not like me.
Here.
Oh, mama! I should get me one of these. You should know that this is the strangest thing I've ever done.
Jump!
Fitzherbert, one might as well know.
I have magic hair that glows when I sing.
What?
I have magic hair that glows when I sing! Flower gleaming glow, let your power shine. Make the clock reverse, bring back what once was mine. We made it!
Her hair glows!
I'm alive.
Her hair glows!
Eugene.
Her hair actually glows.
Eugene.
Why is he smiling at me?
Eugene.
What?
It doesn't just glow.
Huh?
I'll kill him! I'll kill that rider!
I'll kill him.
We'll cut him off.
at the kingdom and get back the crown. Let's go.
Boys! Perhaps you want to stop acting like wild dogs chasing their tails and think for a moment. Oh, please, there's no need for that. Oh, well, if that's all you have desire, then be on your way. I was willing to offer you something worth 1,000 crowns, but that wasn't even the best part. C'est la vie.
Wait, what's the best part?
Yeah, what's the best part?
It comes with revenge on Flynn Rider.
He's so cute. I'm kidding.
Being strangely cryptic as you wrap your hair around my hand.
Sorry, just don't freak out.
Flower gleam and glow, let your power shine. Make the clock reverse, bring back what once was mine. Heal what has been hurt, change the fate's design. Save what has been lost, bring back what once was mine. What once was mine.
Freak out?
I'm not freaking out. I'm just very interested in your hair and the powerful magic it possesses. How long has it been like this?
Forever, I guess. Mother says when I was a baby, people tried to cut it. But when it's cut, it turns brown and it loses all of its power. A gift like that, it has to be protected. That's why I never left the...
You never left the tower? And you want to go back?
No! Yes. It's complicated. So, Eugene Flitz Herbert, huh?
Well, you really don't want to know the sob story of poor orphan Eugene Flitz Herbert. It's a bit of a downer.
I want to know more.
There was this book. A book I used to read to all the younger kids. The Tales of Flinnigan Rider, swashbuckling rogue, richest man alive. Not bad with the ladies either.
Was he a thief too?
Well, no. He was the richest man alive. He could do whatever he wanted to. And I guess for an orphan kid like me, it just seemed like a better option. You can't tell this to anyone. I have a reputation to keep.
Oh, we wouldn't want that to get ruined.
Hey, a man's reputation is all he got. I should go get some firewood. I'll be right back.
Hey, for the record, I like Eugene Flitz Herbert much better than Flynn Rider.
Well, then you'd be the first, but thank you.
Shh. Well, I thought he'd never leave.
Mother, how did you
find you? It was easy, really. I just listened to the sound of complete and utter betrayal. And followed that.
Mother, I'm...
We're going home, Rapunzel, now.
No, Mother! I've been on this incredible journey. I even met someone.
Oh, yes, the wanted thief. I'm so proud. We're going home, now.
No, Mother! I think he likes me.
Likes you? Please, Rapunzel, that's demented. This is why you never should have left. Dear, this whole romance that you've invented just proves you're too naive to be here. Why would he like you? Come on now, really. Look at you! You think that he's impressed? Don't be a dummy. Come with Mummy. Mother...
No!
No. Oh. I see how it is. Rapunzel knows best. Rapunzel's so mature now, such a clever grown-up miss. Rapunzel knows best. Fine, if you're so sure now, go ahead then, give him this.
How did you...
This is why he's here. Don't let him deceive you. Give it to him what you see.
I will.
Trust me, my dear, that's how fast he'll leave you. I won't say I told you so. Go and put him to the test. If he's lying, don't come crying. Mother knows best.
Can I ask you a question? Is there any chance that I would get superhuman strength? Because that would be impressive. Hey, are you okay?
Oh, yeah. I'm just lost in thought, I guess.
Oh. Because I mean superhuman good looks? I have that. But superhuman strength? Oh. Can you imagine the possibilities? Oh. It's getting... pretty late. We should rest. Ah. Well, I hope you're here to apologize.
Hey, stop! Stop it right now! Hey!
Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, hey. Easy, boy. Easy. Down. You're such a good boy, aren't you?
Excuse me?
You're tired from all that chasing and
he's
running.
He's a bad horse.
Oh, he's nothing but a big sweetheart, aren't you? Maximus, listen, today is kind of the biggest day of my life, and I need you not to get him arrested, just for 24 hours, then you can chase each other to your heart's desire. Oh, and it's also my birthday, just so you know.
Time.
Maximus. You ate all the apples. Bravo. Are you okay?
I'm terrified.
Why?
I've been looking out of a window for 18 years, wondering what it would be like at this moment. But what if it isn't all I dreamt it would be?
It will be.
And if it is, what do I do after that?
Well, then that's the best part, I guess. You go on and find another dream.
Wanted to give you this for a while, but I was just scared. And the thing is, I'm not scared anymore. You know what I mean?
I'm starting to. All those days chasing down the age. All those years living in a blur. All that time never truly seeing things the way they were. Now she's here, shining in the starlight. Now she's here, suddenly I see. If she's here, it's all so clear. I'm where I'm meant.
And at last I see the light.
It's like the fog has lifted.
And at last I see the light.
And it's like the sky is new.
And it's warm and real and bright.
And the world. Everything's just fine. There's just this thing I have to take care of. I'll be right back.
Okay.
You are. I've been looking everywhere for you guys since we parted.
So have I, Flynn. I mean, I really.
Okay. Hey, sideburns looking nice, huh? Anyway. I shouldn't have left you guys. I'm so sorry. It was good knowing you. Goodbye. Oh.
Oh.
Holding out on us again.
Again?
Ryder?
Ryder?
We heard you found something. Something much more valuable than a crown. We want the girl instead.
I was starting to think he took the crown and left me.
He did.
No, he wouldn't.
See for yourself.
Eugene! Eugene!
Fair trade. A crown for the girl with the magic hair? How much do you think someone will pay for a glowing hair?
No! No, Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Are you all right? Are you hurt?
I'm fine.
I was so worried about you, so I had to follow you, and then I saw these men attack you, and... Oh my, let's go before they come.
Mother! You were right about everything.
I know, darling. I know.
Let's get this over with, Ryder.
Where are we going? Where did you take her? Tell me now!
It wasn't us! It was the old lady!
Hey,
wait!
Open up!
What's the password?
What?
No!
Open this door!
That's not even close! Bye-bye!
You've got 3 seconds! 1, 2, 3!
Pans, who knew, right? Maximus, it was all you. I'm so sorry. You've been in a certain just... All right, let's go, Rapunzel!
There. It never happened. Now wash up for dinner. I made hazelnut soup. I really did try, Rapunzel. I tried to warn you what was out there. The world is dark, selfish, and cruel. And if it finds even the slightest ray of sunlight, it destroys it. Rapunzel, are you all right?
I'm the lost princess.
Rapunzel, I told you how I feel about the mumbling.
I'm the lost princess.
Marta!
Mother? Or should I even call you that?
Rapunzel, do you even hear yourself? Why would you ask such a ridiculous question?
It was you. It was all you.
Everything that I did was to protect you.
This is your fault. All of it.
Where will you go? He won't be there for you.
What did you do to him?
That criminal is to be hanged for his crimes. Now, don't you worry, dear. Everything is as it should be.
No! You were wrong about the world, and you were wrong about me! And I will never, ever let you use my hair ever again!
Rapunzel! Rapunzel!
You want me to be the bad guy? Fine. Now I'm the bad guy! No!
Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Rapunzel!
Eugene.
I thought I'd never see you again. Rapunzel, are you okay? Rapunzel!
help!
Now look what you've done, Rapunzel. Oh, don't worry, dear. Our secret will die with him. And as for you and I, we are going somewhere where no one will ever find you again! Stop fighting me, Rapunzel! Stop it! No!
I will never stop. For the rest of my life, I will fight! But if you let me save him...
Rapunzel, no!
I'll come with you.
No!
I'll never try to run. I'll never try to escape.
Rapunzel, please don't.
Just let me save him.
Rapunzel, please.
Everything is going to be okay.
But if you do, then you die.
No, everything.
Rapunzel, please.
Everything is going to be okay. I promise.
No! No! What have you done? What have you done? No! No!
Thank you. ever told you I have a thing for nuts?
You can imagine what happened next. The kingdom rejoiced, for the lost princess had now returned. The party lasted an entire week, and honestly, I don't remember much of it. Dreams came true all over the place. That guy went on to become the most famous concert pianist in the world. That guy finally fell in love, and as for this guy, I mean, I assume he's happy. He's never told me otherwise. Thanks for Maximus. Crime in the kingdom disappeared overnight, as did the apples. And thanks for the brothers. I mean, they turned out to actually have hearts. Rapunzel was home and finally had a real family. She was a princess worth waiting for. Beloved by all, she led the kingdom with all grace and wisdom, as did her parents before her. And as for Flynn, well, he started going by Eugene again, stopped all the thieving, and basically turned it all around. But I know what the real question is. Did Rapunzel and Flynn ever get married? Well, I'm pleased to tell you that after years and years of asking, and asking, and asking, and asking.
I said yes. Fine, I asked you first.
And they lived happily ever after.